When I went to Pittsburgh last fall, I had a chance to ride the city's MLK East Busway, and it instantly took a liking to it. Where else could one find a dedicated highway only for buses, capable of drastically reducing travel times while still serving wide swaths of urban territory? Turns out, Hartford. Since 2015, Connecticut's capital has been home to its own busway, known as CT FasTrack, which has been loved by transit nerds and local riders alike. But which system is better? Let's take a look. First of all, the route. The MLK busway starts at Pittsburgh's Penn Station, then runs 9.1 miles east to Swissvale. For much of its route, it parallels an active Norfolk Southern right-of-way. CT FasTrack, meanwhile, starts at Hartford's Union Station, then runs 9.4 miles south to a dedicated terminal in downtown New Britain. For much of its route, it parallels an active Amtrak and CT Rail right-of-way. Buses in both systems join their busways at various points, with some traveling the length of their route, and others using only a portion of it, and most make loops through their respective downtowns. Since it has a 0.3 mile advantage, Hartford wins this category. Next, branding. In Pittsburgh, if you see a bus route that begins with the letter P, it's probably going to run on the MLK busway. But other than that, the buses that run here look exactly like the rest of Pittsburgh's buses. Not so in Hartford. FasTrack buses are painted bright green, easily distinguishable from the blue buses that run elsewhere in the city. Another win for Hartford. Let's take a look at fare collection. In Pittsburgh, whether your bus runs on the busway or the street, the boarding process is the same. You get on, pay cash or scan your phone, and have a seat. Hartford, however, uses a proof of payment system, with fare machines at each FasTrack station, and even placed throughout downtown. When I wrote it, the state of Connecticut was midway through a pilot program to make all buses in the state free, meaning I never had to purchase a ticket. Thanks, Ned Lamont! Another win for Hartford. How about stations? Both systems have decent waiting areas, easily accessible from neighborhood streets. But Hartford goes the extra mile, with standardized design at each station, further cementing the FasTrack brand, and giving users a consistent experience. In addition, unlike Pittsburgh, Hartford has real-time displays showing when buses are arriving in each direction. And the route diagrams are ridiculously intuitive, even if I'm not sure which direction each route circles through downtown. Overall, Hartford wins yet again. Also, this is Berto, who asked me to take his picture. A longtime Hartford resident, he told me he appreciates FasTrack greatly, and on this particular day, he was on his way to a job interview. I hope he got the position. Now for our last category, ridership. According to a 2019 article in the Pittsburgh City Paper, the MLK busway saw about 23,000 riders per day in 2018. In the same year, the FasTrack saw only about 10,000, so finally a win for Pittsburgh. But that said, the MLK busway is considerably older than the FasTrack, so it's had time to cement its role in the community it serves. Plus, Pittsburgh does have about twice as many people as Hartford, so if we adjust for population, the ridership is pretty similar. Overall, Pittsburgh's MLK busway is a great piece of infrastructure, and the CT FasTrack takes everything good about it and makes it even better. Both cities should be proud of their busways. But CT FasTrack is the only one with silver status, according to the Institute for Transportation Development and Policy's Bus Rapid Transit Standards. If Pittsburgh wants to upgrade from their bronze status, it might be time for the Port Authority to make a visit to Connecticut.